We're going to discuss a case study involving the Colgate-Palmolive Company with my guest today, Josuê Muñoz. He is Vice President of Global Supply Chain Demand and Systems with Colgate-Palmolive. Welcome, Josuê. How are you today?
Great.
Thanks for being with us. Now, let's talk about this interesting supply chain challenge that you folks faced over at Colgate-Palmolive. Could you tell me what happened?
So basically two challenges. The first one, our need to customize. So how do we deliver customized product efficiently to our customers? And the second, how do we make the process digital? So how do we connect with our suppliers to be able to be more agile and be able to deliver that customization when it is needed?
Mm-hmm. Of course, you exist in the world of SKU proliferation. Customization of product and just proliferation of products is just out the window with you folks, is it not?
Absolutely.
Was it getting even worse? I mean, you've been...
It continues to be a challenge, and our challenge is we have to make sure that proliferation brings value. We understand that shoppers and customers are looking for differentiation, so we're going to have to proliferate and we're going to have to provide that differentiation, and we have to do it in a way that is efficient for our supply chain.
So what did you mean when you said you needed to go digital? What was manual before that needed to be automated and turned to digital?
The interaction with our suppliers has to be digital. So we have customization partners all over the world. Mm-hmm. They basically take our product and adapt it to the needs, either e-commerce or a specific brick and mortar retailer, a display, or a specific promotional pack. So we want to do this as late as possible in the process. Mm-hmm. And so we needed postponement. Yes, exactly. And so we needed our suppliers of customization to be connected to our systems. We needed to have visibility. We needed to be able to do quality control and quality management. And we needed to integrate them to our whole SAP platform.
Small task, not too difficult, right?
Yes.
Yeah. All right, so you went out looking for a partner to help you achieve this, and it sounds like you chose Newlogy as your partner. Why Newlogy?
We found a solution that was tailored to the need of our supplier to begin with, so we needed to be able to provide something that they were willing to adopt and put in place, and also something that was easily integratable with our platform. And we found this with Newlogy. And so we executed a pilot that proved that even when we went to a not very sophisticated co-packer, as we call them, a customization partner, we were able to put it in place, and it delivered immediate value to that partner and to us. So that made it, it's a selling case. It was easy to sell.
Did the pilot involve a limited number of SKUs?
No, it was their whole operation.
The whole operation.
Yes.
What was limited, though, was the partner that you chose
exactly.
With which to do it.
Exactly. We chose one partner, and we did it with him, and it worked. And so now we're expanding, and we want to take it global.
You make it sound so easy. There must have been some, I don't know, rocks in the road on the way. I mean, talk a little bit about the implementation of the solution.
So again, it is a lot of change management on both sides. So on our side, there's a process change as everything now is visible immediately. So we need to change how we operate. But with our customization partner, it's also a big change. Going from fully manual processes, stacks of paper to be able to manage quality, to iPads on the line, tracking immediately what is being produced, availability of their efficiency, and availability to drill down on where they have bottlenecks. So they changed their whole process and they found efficiencies. And so now when you look at their operation today, it doesn't look anything like it looked before they implemented the system.
Now, every application of new technology also involves a change in business process. What were the challenges there on the human side and the roles that different people played and how they changed?
The roles change, but the good thing is it made their lives easier. So the planners on our side, mm-hmm. with visibility, their life was easier. It was no more emails and spreadsheets and tracking of what was happening. And on their side, it was a total radical re-engineering of the process from papers and sign sheets and to digital. Mm-hmm. When you look at their operation now, it's all pads, iPads, and dashboards and screens.
And how long did the pilot take?
It took about 6 months to get it working, mm-hmm. and then once we created the interfaces and connections to our system, it worked very well.
While you're implementing with that co-packer, you're also doing business with that co-packer.
Oh, absolutely.
So were you working on parallel streams?
It was doing them manual
at the same time over here you were doing the digital aspect.
Absolutely. It was initially that way, but once we switched over, it all became digital very rapidly and was more a question of if we had issues resolving them and making sure that we were able to operate with them with a solution.
What was involved in training both on your end and on the co-packer's end?
Well, on our end, there was a training with our planners, different way of interacting with our customization partner, and on their side, it was total retraining of how the job was done, from papers to pads, and so that took some time. But again, people today all have phones, all have iPads. It's very easy for them to get updated on the new technology.
They weren't strangers to the technology.
No. They're no strangers to technology.
Where was Newlogy in the process of training? Were they on site with you? Were they dealing with you too?
Absolutely.
As well?
They were on site all the time. They were supporting the change. They were adjusting the system to the needs of our customization partner, and so they were collaborating with us totally during the phase of implementation.
Any surprises along the way? Any unexpected outcomes in the act of implementation?
Not really. We knew that the change management piece was going to be critical, so we were prepared to do the training, and we had the right amount of people on the floor making sure that everyone understood what was needed to be done, and we did that, and with the support of Newlogy, we got it done.
Okay, so 6 months were over, the pilot was over, and it was a success with this particular co-packer. Did you then proceed to roll it out to everybody at once, or did you phase that in?
We have a plan, and we're starting to roll it out, and again, we have to sell it in to our customization partner. This is not something that we go and mandate. What we mandate is that we're going to be digitally integrated. Mm-hmm. So our partner has to provide us with the connections and the platform so that we have the visibility that we get with the solution of Newlogy. Mm-hmm. And if they decide to go with something else, okay, but we need that visibility. What is powerful is that they see a case in which it works. So we expect them to choose what is right for them and provide us with that visibility and that connection that we require to be able to be agile.
I can't imagine them saying no. Number one, you're a major customer. Number two, there are great benefits to be had from this technology.
Absolutely.
Why would they balk at it?
They shouldn't.
Yeah, but except to the fact that humans resist change of any kind.
Absolutely. And again, we have different level of customization partners. Some that are highly sophisticated, so they already have some sort of technology to manage their processes. What we're asking them is, you need to integrate with us. So if your technology today does not allow for that digital integration, you're going to have to change it.
So what is the timetable for full rollout?
Well, we have almost 200 partners globally, so we expect to, in the next 2 years, to have all of them digitally connected.
That is quick. 200 partners in 2 years.
Yep.
That's very ambitious, but you think you're going to do it?
I think we can do it.
Yeah. So to date, even though the project is not yet complete, what do you see as being the benefits achieved up to now?
On the quality side, full visibility, that has allowed us to reduce inventory because now we know where everything sits, so we don't have to hold higher inventories while quality processes are being carried out. Mm-hmm. And our partners have seen efficiency. So their processes have been changed, they've become more efficient, and we see higher throughputs, which drives lower cost on our side, and that's what we're also looking for.
Great story, Josuê. Thank you so much for sharing it with us.
Thank you for having me here.
And good luck to you as you go forward with this project. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
I have been speaking with Josuê Muñoz of Colgate-Palmolive Company. Thank you very much for watching.